Officials from the Intelligent Transport Monitoring System, ITMS, a project initiated by President Yoweri Museveni with a promise to revolutionize the transport sector by improving road safety and curtailing criminal activities, today updated the progress of the project. Speaking to journalists at their offices in Kawempe, Kampala, the officials revealed that they had procured the appropriate technology and built the capacity to track stolen vehicles worldwide. Joseph Chigume, one of the officials, said that they have a production capacity of 5,000 digital number plates per day.
So now, how do you determine these numbers?
The ITMS officials also revealed that they can manufacture private number plates, citing an example of the one made for Bukedde.
Series that we printed right now. So it becomes UA, number AA, then AB, AC. It means till the AK we already have at stock.
What does it mean we're going to? We've already installed a number of cameras. They're more high-end technically than the ones that we have now.
While at CID headquarters in Tivoli last Wednesday, President Yoweri Museveni was informed by the Minister of Security, retired Major General Jim Muhezi, that the digital number plates have been rolled and have effectively aided in recovering stolen vehicles. Buganda Road Chief Magistrates Court has granted bail to three anti-corruption protesters who staged a nude protest at Parliament earlier this month. The trio was today granted a non-cash bail of 1 million shillings by Chief Magistrate Ronald Kaizi after spending 10 days on remand. Nora Kovusinje, Praise Aloikin Opoloje, and Nikemitoma Chenzibo were arrested near Parliament as they attempted to march calling for the resignation of Speaker Anita Among. They have since denied the offense of common nuisance as slapped against them by the state, according to Section 148, Subsection 1 of the Penal Code Act. While granting them bail, Kaizi held that the offense against the trio was bailable. He also directed that sureties execute a non-cash court bond of 2 million shillings, adjourning the case to October 1st. Former Makerere University law professor, Professor Sylvia Tamale, who has written extensively on nude protests, stood surety for Praise Aloikin, one of the nude protesters. The prosecution, led by Ivan Chaze, told the court that inquiries in the case were complete.
Your Worship, as it was clearly indicated in the question that these applicants were half naked by the time when you were charged. So we don't know what will happen the next time they are here.
According to the charge sheet, the prosecution stated that Kobusinje, Aloikin Chenzibo, and others still at large on September 2, 2024, at Parliamentary Avenue, Kampala, held a procession in the middle of the road while half naked and with writings on their bodies, an act not authorized by the law, thereby causing annoyance or obstruction or inconvenience to the public in the exercise of common rights.
Shall execute a court bond of 1 million not cash. It will shall execute a bond of 2 million not cash. As person to that court on the 1st of October 2024 at 9 o'clock.
U.S. Secretary of State Anthony Blinken today called for the protection of aid workers after U.N. staffers were killed in Gaza. He argued that a U.S.-backed ceasefire was the best way to ensure their safety. Blinken, however, also said that Hamas, at war with Israel since October 7th attack, bore some responsibility.
With regard to the attack, look, the first thing that's usually important to underscore is the essential, vital, imperative work of humanitarians in Gaza and, for that matter, around the world. And it's essential that those activities be protected and indeed be facilitated. We need to see humanitarian sites protected.
UNRWA said six of its staffers had been killed in two Israeli air raids on the Nusrat school and its surroundings, drawing statements of outrage around the world. Blinken has been pushing for a truce deal for weeks.